many Ugandans in ethnic communities, minority communities, cannot afford to pay for health services either in government or public hospitals. That's according to a new report by the Equal Opportunities Commission. The report was handed over to the Speaker of Parliament today, together with its grim contents. In his remarks, Jacob Olanya spoke of the need to fight corruption, especially since the last leadership of the Equal Opportunities Commission was scandalized with allegations of corruption. Let's take a look.
The 8th annual report on the state of equal opportunities in Uganda for the financial year 2020-2021 indicates that despite positive strides in the health sector, the cost of health services in both government and private health facilities have remained unaffordable for many Ugandans.
There's some form of payment. There was some form of payment made by patients both in government and private health facilities. Most of the respondents, 78.5%, paid less than 100,000. 12.1% paid between 100,000 Uganda shillings and 150,000. Much as the payment may appear small, many persons belonging to minority ethnicities could not afford, which hindered access to health services.
The chairperson of the Equal Opportunities Commission, Safia Nalule Juko, has also asked Parliament to investigate the appalling state of public health facilities.
Honourable Speaker, the state of our health facilities is alarming. Even currently, you find that what is happening, I was there like 1 week ago, you find that the beds are empty, not because people are not sick, but people cannot afford. But even the availability of the health personnel is actually wanting. Maybe Parliament can make an impromptu visit to these health facilities.
The report, which was handed over to the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, also discovered a shortage of secondary schools in areas of ethnic minorities. This has hindered accessibility to secondary and tertiary education as many pupils drop out of schools after primary 7.
Most of the areas where the ethnic minority groups resided at least had at least one education facility within their community. However, there were no secondary schools. Secondary level and tertiary education is still inaccessible and still wanting in many parts of the ethnic minority communities. Many pupils from ethnic minorities complete primary level but do not further their education due to the lack of secondary schools within their communities. With regard to distance, more than half, 53.3%, mentioned that schools were 2 to 3 kilometers away from their homes.
The report also says people with disabilities have continued to face difficulties in accessing employment. 49% of persons with disabilities are not employed, whereas 41% are engaged in the informal sector. Even among the few employed PWDs, 48.8% are paid below 100,000 shillings per month.
The number of persons with disabilities that the commission's team interviewed, that is 49.6%, were not employed. 41.2% were engaged in informal employment, while only 9.2% were engaged in informal employment. With regard to all other forms of employment analyzed, that is informal employment, formal employment, public sector, formal employment, private sector, more males with disabilities, that is 29.8%, were engaged in employment in comparison with their female counterparts, who comprise 20.6%. Persons with disabilities generally face difficulties in accessing employment. However, men with disabilities were usually more likely to have jobs than women with disabilities.
Upon receiving the report, Olanya cautioned the new leadership of the Equal Opportunities Commission against repeating bad history of corruption scandals that haunted the past leadership.
Of the Equal Opportunities Commission, I welcome you to Parliament. I want to thank you for fulfilling your constitutional obligation, something you are mandated to do. And also thank you for having taken over the leadership of this commission. And I notice that there might be only one survivor from the older commission. There are two survivors. And I think the same applies to staff. I think, Chair, for a start, we should avoid a repeat of history of what happened. and we stick with our projections for the future, because the sector that you head now is critical in terms of trying to tilt the picture towards an equilibrium that is sustainable.
Ulanya also emphasized the need for the government to invest in wealth creation programs to empower vulnerable communities. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.